In this video, I'm going to introduce you to 3D in AutoCAD. When we work with 3D, normally we've been working with, if you look down here in the corner, we've got what's called a UCS, that's your user coordinate system. It tells us where our y-axis is, where our x-axis is. But once we start working with 3D, we've actually got a z-axis, and that's what gives it depth. So before, when we've done isometric drawings, they look like they could be 3D, but they're actually flat drawings. There's no depth to them at all. We drew that all with just flat lines on the xy plane. So I have drawn on this screen one just totally flat rectangle and one box that's actually drawn in 3D. So it's hard to tell which one's which when we're looking at it from this view. We're looking at it in a 2D view where we're just seeing the X and Y plane. What I'm going to do is show you how we can get ourselves into that 3D mode so you can actually see the difference here. So the first thing to do is let's change our workspace. So our workspace right now is called Drafting and Annotation. If you pull this down, you can see there's 3D Basics, 3D Modeling. Here's one that I created, my own custom workspace. But everybody has Drafting and Annotation, 3D Basics, and 3D Modeling. If you don't see that pull down menu up here, click on this last little arrow and just put a little check mark next to workspace. There's also the option down here where you see the gear on the status bar, and you can just click on that arrow and you can see those same options as well. I like to have it up here just because you can see the name of it at any time. I can glance up there and see which workstation I'm working in. But I'm going to pull this down. There's two different 3D workstations that you can work in. There's one called 3D Basics, and watch what happens. My ribbon changes. I like the idea of 3D Basics. It's nice and clean. It's just got really big boxes up here. But ultimately, it is a little more cluttered, but I like 3D modeling for the one that I actually work with. There's just so many more options, and when it comes down to it and I'm working in 3D, I need more than just super basic things. So it's definitely more cluttered, but as you can see, there's a whole lot more options here. So that's the first thing we're gonna do to get into 3D mode is we're gonna put ourselves into that 3D modeling workspace. Once we're in that 3D modeling workspace, the next thing that we're gonna do is on the view ribbon, I'm still on the I'm on the home ribbon, but the view panel, right now you can see I'm in 2D wireframe. If I pull that down, I can choose different types of visual styles. I like the one called conceptual, and we'll actually walk through that in a different video looking at each one of these. But putting it into conceptual, now I can kind of see one of these is a solid box, whereas one is just a hollow, just a flat 2D square or rectangle. Now that I've got it in the conceptual style, notice my UCS changed. I can see X and I can see Y, but now I can see a little hint of a blue one that's a Z axis. So I've got the conceptual. I'm gonna click here. Right below this is the view. I'll pull this down and you can see I've got what are 2D views, top, bottom, left, right, front, back. We know what our six views are, but now we have other views as well. So we've got southwest isometric, southeast isometric, northeast isometric, and northwest isometric. So we know what isometric is. It's the one that kind of looks like it's 3D, but you see lines going off at that 30 degree angle. So I'm gonna choose one of these and let's just choose southeast isometric. Once we do that, did you see the whole screen just rotated? Now I'm viewing this in a 3D view. I can see that I've got a solid box here as opposed to the rectangle. Before, I was just viewing it in the top view, and that's why they looked like they were the same. You couldn't see any depth. Now, I do have my UCS over here changed. We saw before that it got colorful the minute I put it into conceptual, but here now I can see my x-axis, my y-axis, my z-axis, so I can see that I'm in the 3D mode. Here's a cool thing that you can do. If you hold down your shift key and you hold down your wheelie ball, that round, you know, the wheel in the middle of your left and right mouse, I'm holding down shift and I'm holding down that wheelie ball, and I can come in here, and this is called orbiting. So I can orbit and I can view this box from all different angles, however I want to view it. Again, I'm still holding down those buttons, but that's just like a quick orbit that we can do. I can always go reset myself back to an isometric view. And that's it. That's how we're going to get ourselves into the isometric mode. I'll make another video on just breaking down the different views that we have, and then also how to start drawing objects within 3D, how to modify and manipulate 3D objects, and ultimately we'll get into how to do these projects in 3D.